many entrepreneurs struggling to find funding, some small business owners are starting their companies with nothing but their own savings. In our new segment called Your Online Business, we take a look at these so-called ultralights, many of which focus on e-commerce. We'll find out how they start online with a clear focus on social media in an effort to become profitable as quickly as possible. Think you need millions of dollars to launch a new company? Well, you don't. Meet these entrepreneurs who have done it on a shoestring.
CarMade was started with pretty much $0.
We each put in $1,000, so it was a $2,000 startup.
I put about $7,000 of my own money initially into the company.
These companies are called ultralights. Business founded with practically no capital.
The idea is that you're not going out and seeking venture capital. It's all money that's straight out of your own pocket and out of the organic nature of the business and what the business is generating on its own.
Graham Lawler, the founder of Ultralight Startups New York, says this business model is right for the times.
Investors are only giving money to successful serial entrepreneurs or people that already have traction. And so you need to get some traction first. And the way that you do that is starting with the revenue first and then going on to scale afterwards.
Everyone laughs at me and thinks that it takes hundreds of thousands of dollars to get a business off the ground. It really takes time, a lot of time, plus a little money.
Hamilton Caldwell started his business, Maya Yogurt, on the stove in his New York City apartment.
I went from sitting on a trading desk the size of a football field to running the company off my couch.
When Caldwell started Maya, he knew he was going at it alone.
It took a little bootstrapping. I gave this thing everything I had.
While leveraging the marketing power of Facebook and Twitter, Caldwell spends the majority of his time talking to customers at grocery stores in the New York City area and visiting the Pennsylvania facility where, in ultralight fashion, he has outsourced his yogurt production.
We're in the store 7 days a week promoting this thing, getting in front of the consumer, really trying to get this message to catch on. But the product is really paramount to the business, to getting it to the next level.
If you were to start a yogurt business, you know, 10 or 20 years ago, you might start with building your own production facility and building your own testing facility. And I think the fact that he's using a shared kitchen and a shared facility, he's able to produce his yogurt at a much lower cost.
John Murch and his partner Brett Snowden have also been able to keep costs down at their ultralight, U-Blanket.
My background's computer science. His background's mechanical and electrical engineering. So he does the hardware, I do the software. Kind of works out.
The pair took to the web to start making blankets out of old t-shirts. They had the business up and running in no time.
We hired a seamstress who was able to do the sewing manufacturing for us, and then I worked on building the site, and it was about a one-month startup. Originally looking to grow and build our own manufacturing facility, but keeping with the ultralight motto, we decided to outsource and contract the work.
Murch and Snowden are the company's only staffers. But the pair says that has actually helped them streamline their operations.
Neither Brett or I could sew, so it's definitely a learning experience at the beginning of this. And, you know, we've been able to kind of understand what needs to happen and also work on ways to improve and speed up the process.
So far, customers have learned about U-Blanket through online searches, social media, and friends and family.
We have not spent a dollar in advertisement yet.
Fry and his business partners, Dave Gorham and Jason Nelson, haven't spent a dollar on advertising either.
CarMade is an online portfolio service for artists and creative people to display their work online, so basically to show off what they produce.
The site started off as Gorham's personal portfolio, and thanks to word of mouth, its popularity has grown. That allowed the trio to make CarbonMade a full-time business.
It's really just about keeping, like, being very frugal and keeping expenses low, and then hoping that more and more revenue comes in every month.
Rather than trying to recruit more customers, CarbonMade uses revenue to focus on improving the experience of the company's approximately 300,000 current users.
For an ultralight, you want to build a simple product because you're very few people to start. We had to basically launch with a paid plan from the start, and you need that kind of business model where you're going to make money from day one. Most of the money is spent on the product, developing the product and the team and the people around it.
If your business is profitable and it's growing, you don't have to take external capital and you can continue to grow it indefinitely. And I think that's what Spencer's doing.
While CarbonMade has found success, Fry admits that the ultralight model isn't perfect. The challenges he and other entrepreneurs face are similar.
Well, I think everything may take a little longer as a self-funded company because you don't have as much access to capital.
It took us a while to kind of save up some money to move into a larger space. And from that, you know, maybe we could have done quicker turnaround times.
Despite this, Lawler says the ultralight model does have a clear advantage. You'll know your business better than anyone else.
It really forces the best practices on you from the beginning. It forces you to understand your business, you know, from a very intimate level from the very first stage, right? I mean, you're not hiring somebody to do your marketing for you and hiring somebody to do your design for you and hiring somebody to do your engineering for you. You're doing all that yourself.